Gone are the days of only an hour of computer time after school for kids, because now that computer time is school time. School districts like Omaha Public Schools have gone fully virtual until October, overwhelming screen time for kids. But it's not all bad, as children's pediatrician Dr. Shannon Gotzel explains.
This type of screen time is different than what we think of with video games, television, movies.
It's different in a good way. It's interactive, meaning students are still physically writing, coloring, and getting creative.
I've seen some teachers doing a little bit of an integration of yoga in the middle of their class. So I think teachers are being incredibly creative during this time.
But it's not all great either.
Even though teenagers probably use tech more than anybody, it still can affect their development.
Students can become burnt out, wired, and not get enough sleep. When we asked OPS officials how they plan on addressing these issues, in a statement, they said there are specific challenges a family may face to attend daily classes remotely. We asked that families work with their school principal and classroom teacher to identify individual solutions that may be available. And there's some individual solutions that can be done right at home, including taking small breaks to move around, eating healthy, as more computer time can lead to more unhealthy snacking, still getting that 30 to 60 minutes of daily physical activity, making sure kids are getting enough sleep, and to the dismay of teenagers everywhere, limiting other technologies.
My biggest thing is what I've told parents is that trying to make everything positive when it comes to their screen time, because social media can turn very negative, video games can turn negative.
Full remote learning is new for everyone, students, teachers, and of course, parents.
There's really not a choice, right? You know, and so you don't want to be so hard on yourself as a parent or a guardian of a child who has no choice when it comes to e-learning.
And we'll all get through it one click
at a time. Reporting in Omaha, Rudolph Sinaita, 3 News Now.